2x4's I need to cut up out of this log. This is a big old boy. It's about 9 foot long. I need some 8 footers, so I got this 9 foot log up here. And I told y'all in the last video, if I'm not mistaken, it was the last video I made, always put the little end on this end, except for when they're big. I'm gonna go get my measuring tape and measure the end of this. That's why I put the big end on this end, because I know I'll be maxed out on this mill. Let's see what it measures up to. All right, it's 24 inches on the small end. And I'm looking right at 30 inches on the big end. And it's got a bad edge on it. This is the butt end of the log, so gonna be some whittling down, but we're gonna get some 2x4s out of this thing. There ain't a knot in it. It's beautiful. Going to be some beautiful 2x4s, nice and straight. I'm kind of curious how many we're going to get out of there. It's going to be a bunch. I know I'm going to be cutting some 3.5 inch slabs off, throwing them to the side where I can get it down to where I can work with it. It's just too big for me to be handling, fighting with all of them at the same time. So I'm going to cut some 3 inch slabs. Well, I'm going to take the slabs off and cut some good 3.5 inch boards off of it, put them to the side, and I'll put them back up and cut them again. First thing I'm gonna do is turn this fan on, because it is hot. Get this mill going, let's cut up some lumber.
Thank you.
Well, I see one of my little buddies flying around. Y'all see that little wasp right there? I'm gonna check that lid and make sure there ain't no more in there. I've done been hit twice this year. Them things right there hurt. Let me check this out and find out where they're at. Well, I didn't see but one little wasp. But I'm making sure. Them little babies right there hurt. I've been stung by yellow jackets, bees, everything else. They hurt. They don't feel nothing like that wasp thing. That baby hurts. I've already had them getting started in my sawmill and these little holes in the side going in the frame. And come out of there when I'm sawing and work me over. So I keep a close eye out on them now. But guys, if you notice, I'm cutting this stuff. That's 24 inches wide. I'm pushing that sawmill with one hand. Take your rope off. Makes a world of difference. I'm also running straight diesel. No water whatsoever, just a small drip of diesel. Your blades last a lot longer. Guys, I got some turbo blades coming from Woodmizer. I'm kind of anxious to try them. If you know anything about the turbo blades, let me know if there's any difference. Are they any better? They talk about the turbo blades being a better blade. If you got any knowledge on them, let me know. I'm running just a standard blade right now, but I'm going to try them turbo blades as soon as they get here. I'm waiting on the UPS to bring them in. But just remember, if you take that rope off, it's a lot easier to cut. I was worried about these big logs because I would use it sometimes to be able to go through the log real smooth and slow. Guys, I'm pushing in one hand. It's still no problem going through it. Let's fire it up and cut some more. inches wide, cutting like butter. Got a little bitty bad spot right here in the middle. Got a couple little bitty small knots and one good size knot right here. But that ain't that bad. That must have been some limbs when the tree was real small. It growed over them and there was none showing in the butt of the log. But that makes 5 3.5 inch slabs coming off of here. That's a lot of timber force. We'll give you a count when we get it done. I got two more slabs, 3.5 inches wide by 16. That'll give you another 20 right there. Plus the slabs down there cut off from the sides. Get another 6 there. There's 4 right there, so that's another 30. Plus I got 24 of them in the back of the truck. That's a lot of 2x4s out of one tree. Can't complain at all. But guys, I'm not going to finish cutting these other ones up. My battery's fixing to go dead, and I'm burnt out. I'm fixing to sit down and relax a little while. It's been a long day. Guys, if you like this kind of content, give me a thumbs up. And Jared's been in the pottery house glazing all day. She's been in there for 8 hours today, just glazing, putting the color on the stuff. And she got the kiln running. She'll have some stuff coming out tomorrow. But she's done got every bit of that stuff sold, if I'm not mistaken. She sells it before it even comes out of the kiln. So if y'all want some of that pottery, put your order in. Let her know. Guys, if you ain't never watched a pottery video and watched some of the stuff coming out of that kiln, y'all need to check it out. That's some beautiful stuff. Very good pottery. She's doing a good job. I'm proud of her. Guys, God bless, and I'll catch you on the next one. Bye-bye.